Jason, now who called this?
Yeah, man. Yeah, you have a couple times. You
were I've been wrong.
You've been wrong.
Five times.
You know what, man? All those times that you were wrong, it feels really, really nice right now, honestly. So just thank you, man.
You are so welcome. My gosh, this is so well deserved. And you know, that reel was just so great, Jason. It was kind of like, and no disrespect to everybody else, was great too, but it was just such a great reel. You know, it was very strong. And so when your name was called, what happened? I haven't seen, were the kids there, I heard?
Yeah, dude, it was hilarious. I have a video of it that I'll probably post at some point, but it was like, we got some food. There was like kids' plates and food all over the place. And, you know, we're watching it obviously live from the CBS feed. So yeah, man, it was a little surreal. My mom and dad were FaceTiming, which they were FaceTiming my brother's computer from his house. It was like the levels of you know, whatever it is, viewership that we were watching was pretty funny. But yeah, man, it was, I just kind of blanked out for a second. I was like, was that my name? I couldn't really hear it. So, but it feels, I don't know, to be honest, it feels relieving being able to kind of somewhat thank all the people that you've forever been supported by and all the things that have got you to this moment. And you know, in your head, you're like, you're going to be there in your tux and you're going to be surrounded by all that your peers that really this is all about. And you go up there and you say it. So it was like hugs and kisses and tears from within a couple minutes. And then, you know, my son is like, can I go watch Pets 2 again? And I was like, yeah, I'll unpause it. And Rome's like, can I have another piece of pizza? It's like, yeah, here you go. And then Rome was like, do you want another glass of wine? I was like, yeah, sure. And then, so, you know, it's different for sure. But I hope that this goes down in history as the one and only time that we did it this way. And I am honored to be a part of it in this capacity.
Six times. And I would feel the same way. Like, I'm just relieved you won because I can't keep saying and then you're looking at me like you lied again. So, and I want to say about your mom and dad, who I've met a few times. And who I just
you have, yeah.
I mean, they must be thrilled. Did they say anything? Have you talked to them or what happened?
Yeah, they were actually, funny enough, they're in Kananaskis camping right now with my with my aunts and uncles and a couple other friends. So they're sitting in the trailer watching their feed of my brother's computer. Yeah, you know, I couldn't really hear. My dad, I think I saw him at a corner of eye jump up and down in the trailer. And my mom, I would imagine, started crying because I don't think she, you know, we were both kind of crying in there for a second.
Of course.
It's just, you know, it's cool.
You know, it was so amazing and so cool. After we posted the interview we did earlier in the week, I did you see like the outpouring of people like Kimberly and just more than that, just so many people were saying, Jason's got to win this. Jason's got to win this. It was just coming out of the woodwork. And I was like, I feel like it was like, this is so meant to be. And they were also behind you, Jason. And I want to speak to that. Like, you've made such an impact and people have loved you in this community for the time you've been in it. I could feel all that love coming to you just in the little interview we did. And that must be special for you to know that.
Yeah, it's incredible. It's, sorry.
It's okay.
Yeah, I mean, just Kimberly alone, like I could go off for about a half hour speaking about the support that I've had from her over the years and how much I learned. Steve texting me right after. Maurice sitting there, you know, being part of that, opening the ceremony. Those are people that I've looked up to for so long. You know, the amount of text messages that came, but I didn't think my iPhone worked that quickly. I'm always bitching about how slow it is and all of a sudden it explodes. So yeah, I mean, you know, and then on the Y&R team, just producers and Peter and Josh and, you know, everybody just being, yeah, I don't know, man. You just, you know, it's like, well, I was texting with Doug real quick and so many people that have built this industry for many, many years. I am so honored to be kind of like riding on the coattails in a way of the work that they've done. And I feel very blessed to be able to try and be part of the process to keep it going. And I try to do what I can to honor daytime television. And I've always kind of felt that way. And I do still really believe in the art of it. And to me personally, that's what kind of gets me off. And so that's fun for me. And I just, you know, I count my lucky stars all the time that I'm able to do this for a living. And I just respect the hell out of so many people and everybody that does what they do to put the show on every single day. It's incredible. And you know how difficult it is. I mean, you, for instance, like you are a part of that. Everybody that speaks to this kind of daytime for over the years, they're all a part of keeping it buoyant, and it deserves to be. And, you know, and I feel honored to be a part of it. You know, it's, yeah.
Yeah. I mean, I think we're all such a little microcosm group that's so supportive of each other in ways, and we're all kind of in this together. You know, this, we need this to promote this. You guys do the acting. We're all part of this machine to keep it alive, because I think it's an undervalued art form in a way.
Yeah. Well, yeah, it is. And it also just kind of goes to show is when we kind of believe in a cause, how well we can all work together. You know, and that's like, I mean, daytime has always done their job about telling stories that are poignant and kind of showing people a different view. And I think more than ever right now, we all have the opportunity to shine light in a different way than we have in the past. And I think the daytime community can do their part in doing that. And I think that's what I believe most in, is that their ability to kind of put themselves out there and to do it in the manner that we do it on a short amount of time and with all the support that we do it in. I mean, that's kind of like, I think that's what we all believe in. And so I'm glad to be a part of that.
I can't believe you won the
COVID. I can't either. I'm so relieved. I mean, Kelly Monaco texts me and she's like, it's about time. And I was like, yeah, sure. I mean, this could have been number 10. It could have been number 2. You just don't know. And right now it even feels surreal. I'm sitting at home in a rental in the backyard. It's like my wife is bathing the kids.
Where's the Emmy Award?
Yeah, it's interesting. So hey man, I appreciate it.
All right. Well, congratulations, Jason. I'll let you get on with it. You know, much love. You know, I'm always in your corner and I'm absolutely thrilled. Six is the charm. The six was the charm.
All right. Six was a charm.
Six was the charm. I will see you soon.
Thanks, man.
All right. Bye-bye.
Bye.